obviously you guys have been through some ups and some downs, but still together. So what is the secret here?
What you would say the secret is? What you thought?
I mean, you know, the secret would be you got to understand you're going to deal with a lot of criticism from people telling you how you should be in a relationship. And I don't think people understand me and Rasheeda have been married 25 years, you know. First of all, we best friends. We're friends first. And, you know, we could talk about a lot of things, but you got to have a friendship and you got to understand everything ain't going to be perfect. Talk to your grandma, your grandpas, and figure out how these relationships make it, because it's about a team here. You know, you need a, I always say you need a day and a night. You need a plus and a minus. So it's the team. Yeah, so it's like a team thing, and that's what we do. We work as a team, you know. I get beat up a lot, but it is what it is.
What about for you, Rasheeda? Because you put us through some things, okay? So what is that for you on your end?
Allegedly. Okay, so what was the question again?
What's your secret to stay happily married after all these years?
You know what? I think with Kirk and I is more, I hate to even say this because people just talk so much, but it's the communication and really like understanding each other, because over time, just because you're married to somebody doesn't mean you really know them like you should or understand them like you should. And throughout years, I guess for us, because we've been together for such a long time, you know, you evolve and change in life as you get older. So understanding each other and being open to that, you know what I'm saying? Right. And then most of anything, really communicating with each other and just being real with each other.
Yo, what's good? We back with another episode of Another Day in the Life. And today we're going to talk about Rasheeda and Kirk. Now, if you like me, I have never watched Love and Hip Hop. Nothing, no hate towards it. It's just not my thing. But I saw this video with Rasheeda and Kirk, and they were talking about relationships and like what you would have to do to sustain a healthy marriage and relationship for a long period of time. And I was like, this is some good advice. And then I even saw in a later video, you're gonna see in this video, Scrappy saying like she's a good woman because that she never left him and all this. But going through the comments, like everybody hated this marriage. That was primarily women, clearly, but everybody hated this marriage, and I was like, it can't be that bad, right? So I went down a little mini rabbit hole, because you know me, I do the Googling so you don't have to. I went down a mini rabbit hole to see if what he did was so bad to this woman that it warranted the hate that it did, or that the hate that it garnered. So yeah.
Rasheeda, is this a lot of pressure to feel like you are this iconic couple to people and they look up to you?
You don't never, I wouldn't wish this on nobody.
I'm sorry.
See her cry.
See, that's what I'll be talking about.
It's kind of at the end of the day, y'all, on some real it's like when you in a marriage and a commitment, and I grew up with this man, and he's hurt me, and it's crazy because he's also helped me grow to become the woman I am today. But when you hurt somebody and you dismantle a bond, that's the hardest thing to get over. Heartbreak is like the worst thing to get over. And I don't want to cry no more, I promise y'all. I said I ain't want to cry about this no more, because at the end of the day, this is a lesson. But more than anything, this is a lesson for you. For you to understand what you've done. You know, we have children, and that's the main thing that bothers me, is we have children who look at you like a f-ing superhero. You are a father, and for you to do this, you didn't think about all the f-ing consequences of this. And not only did you hurt me, but you broke me.
So I saw that video, I was like, God damn. Like, I don't know the history, but I can feel the emotion. So I continued. So I just went online and it was like, Kirk cheats. And then, like, this came up.
How you like that? Get out of my way, Rasheeda.
Like, what are you doing?
Yo, yo, yo.
Oh,
Shut up.
Yeah, that's the $7,000
bike. Don't be looking at me like I'm damn crazy.
Yo, get your
I'll show you who's crazy.
Yes, mama.
I'll show you who's crazy.
Just go. Don't. Just go.
Yeah, go.
A problem.
Real talk, I am not mad at my mama right now. All Kirk done put me through, he better be glad she didn't run his ass over.
You done the wrong damn person. I'm not through with you.
What the is your mama problem?
That on fire.
Then I saw like videos of him and this girl named Jasmine. Jasmine is a woman he got an outside child with. So yeah, boom, boom, boom. Then lady get catch with the same woman, like, trying to text her and all this. And I was like, wait, this nigga can't win for losing. But you know what part got me that nobody talks about? The part when she admitted early in the relationship she cheated.
We've had dishonesty from both sides of us in this marriage. We've had infidelities from both sides of us in this marriage.
Nah.
What?
Oh my God.
My situation was a very long time ago.
Rasheeda.
And I take it off for broke. But you gotta call a spade a spade. It's infidelity on both sides. Nah, they've been married 25 years. I would hate to believe like she's still getting into the cheating shit. And like, at some point you have to grow up. Like, and that's the reason I'm recording this video. Like, man, you have to grow up. Like, you could knock that shit out in your 20s and even maybe your 30s, but after you're like 40, 50, like, what you doing? You have children, you raising a family, like, bro, don't let your children see that, because they can think that's normal. Like, try to do better. Like, you didn't like it when you saw, because a lot of us did, you saw your mommy getting cheated on from your daddy, you didn't like it. So, don't be the same person. And maybe that's probably why we the way we are. And I'm not perfect. I don't think men really good at being monogamous. But if you're going before God for the marriage, at least try. Like, you know? I just feel it's a lack of trying. But you have to give credit to Rasheeda because she never left. Women these days will leave for anything. Oh, you short on the bill? Leave. You ain't eat the food I cook, leave. You didn't mop the floor, leave. You leave the car and eat, leave. These women have no stickability. So, if you could find somebody like Rasheeda, stay with her. Honestly, like, the next time I get married, because I've been divorced before, but the next time I get married, I want a Rasheeda. I want someone who's always going to be there, no matter what. No matter how people look at us, because you got to think of the backlash she gets from how people look at her. Oh, she's ass. She stayed with this boy. He doing this. He doing that. She's still with him. Yeah, I want one of those. That's a real woman. Like, she's what I call a classic woman. You know, you got good women. You got good women who are there, but they ain't really solid. They don't have the stickability. But a classic woman, I was like, a great grandmother type of woman. That's, I don't know where he found that, but he would do good not to fumble that.
Rasheeda ain't never leaving Kirk. Like, that is, I talked to Rasheeda and Yandy last night. Them mother ain't never leaving them, man. They real women. Real women don't leave they men, cuz, at all, cuz they know what, they know the future. The future is go far and beyond these. These weak, they leave they. They want to be on their own. They think they strong. Okay, be strong. You feel what I'm saying? Be on your own. Raise all your kids. Do all, everything.
Now, I don't entirely agree with what Scrappy said, but he does have a point. And here's how I'm going to close this video. When a man cheats and you decide to leave, right? What's the game plan? Oh, I can find another one, and he's not gonna cheat. Newsflash, women. Most of these niggas cheat, and instead of ain't cheating, they'll admire it. Any nigga who worth something probably taken. Let me let y'all know that. Any nigga who worth something probably taken, and that's why y'all end up sharing a lot of niggas, because the ones y'all want already with somebody. So what he do? He try to give you some time, whatever. Y'all falling off of a big follow. But when you see a quality man, most times women don't leave. She do all of that, have a big thing, even if it go public, but she stay with him. Y'all women, on the other hand, love to give up these good niggas, and people jump on that like that. People love to jump and take advantage on what you take for granted. Like, what's the goal? Like, you have a man taking care of kids within his, helping you pay your bills, or supporting you in whatever endeavors you gotta get on, and you gonna leave him for niggas out here? I might as well tell you, the niggas out here just wanna fuck. And that's it. Past that, what? Y'all do something safe? Y'all do something safe with you, yeah? It's just another day in the life. And keep on living. We out.